Hello everyone, I'm Priyanka Shain. Welcome to my YouTube channel Mathalite. In this video, we learn about simultaneous linear equations. Now, before moving on to simultaneous linear equations, let us understand what are linear equations. Linear equations, they are written in standard form as ax plus by plus c equal to 0. This is the standard form of a linear equation. Linear equation means there will be an equal to sign. Okay, so always keep in mind equation bol rahe, so there will be an equal to sign. Linear means this equation represents a line. With the help of this equation, you can draw a line, a straight line. Okay, so that is why it is called a linear equation. So, linear equation has a standard form ax plus by plus c equal to 0. You can also rewrite it as ax plus by equal to minus c. Okay, shifting c on the other side. Now, what are a, b and c? What are x and y? What do they represent? A, b and c, they are constants. Okay, so they have some value, some constant value, which are real numbers. Okay, so all the numbers that you have learned so far, natural numbers, whole numbers, integers, rational numbers, irrational numbers, decimals, fractions. So a, b and c can have any of these values, any of the real values. Okay, so a, b and c are constants where they can have any real value. X and y, unka value fixed nahi hai, that is why they are called variables. So x and y ka value will keep on changing in the equation, so that is why they are called variables. Having degree 1, so powers of x and y will be 1. Okay, it cannot have power other than 1. So if it is not having power 1, it will not be a linear equation. Okay, so for linear equation, x and y will have degree 1. All right, so a, b and c are constants, x and y are variables having degree 1. Alright, and this is the standard form of the linear equation. So over here, there are some examples of linear equations. X plus 4y equal to 5. In standard form, we can say it will be x plus 4y minus 5 equal to 0. Okay, so this will be the standard form. What will be the value of a, b and c? We know x and y are variables. What will be the value of a, b and c over here? Yahan pe kuch nahi hai. So it is 1, not 0, but 1. So a is 1, b is 4, c is minus 5. So you have to include negative sign if there is any. Okay. For second one, a will be 2, b will be minus 1 and c will be minus 7, shifting this on the other side. For third one, a will be 3, b will be minus 5 and c will be minus 10. Okay, so this was all about the linear equations. Now moving on to simultaneous linear equations. Simultaneous means what? At the same time. Okay, so if you consider two equations, linear equations. So over here I have written two linear equations where x and y, if you consider a particular value of x and particular value of y, it will be satisfying both the equations. Okay, so you have to make sure both the linear equations have same variables. Okay, they should have same variables. X, y hai to yahan pe bhi x, y hona chahiye. Yahan pe y, z nahi chalega. Yahan pe m, n nahi chalega. Okay, so yahan pe mn hai, toh yahan pe bhi mn hona chahiye. Okay, so whatever variables you are considering in one equation, that same variables should be there in the other equation. Okay, so if you consider the value of these variables, okay, and these values, if they satisfy both the equations, then these two values are the solution of these two equations. Okay, agar main x equal to 5 and y equal to 2, if I substitute that in one equation, first equation, 5 plus 2 is equal to 7, So we are getting LHS equal to RHS. This means it is satisfying the equation. When we get LHS equal to RHS, it means it is equal, satisfying the equation. What about substituting in second equation? X equal to 5. So it will become 3 into 5 and minus y is equal to 2. So it will become 15 minus 4, that is 11. So it is equal to RHS. So over here, x and y, one value will be there of x and one value of y, which will be satisfying both the equations. Okay. So these are simultaneous linear equations. So when you consider two linear equations at the same time and you find out the value of x and y such that it satisfies both the equations, then this value of x and this value of y will be the solution of both the equations. Okay, so in this chapter we'll be solving these equations to find out the value of x and y, okay, which is satisfying both the equations using different methods. So let us now move on to the exercises.